recently. I was doing a series of videos on servers and networking where I showed a lot of quick ways to get servers set up and do some quick and dirty networking stuff real fast. Now, I get a lot of questions on them. People seem to really like this series, and I thank you to my Patreon viewers, my Patreon supporters, for voting on that topic. It seems to be very popular. And if you're one of my Patreon supporters and you want to see more of that, be sure to let me know or whatever topic it is you want to see. If you're not a Patreon supporter, be sure to go over to patreon.com/MetalX1000. You know, become a supporter, help me make more videos, and get a say on what gets made. But I also want to point out that I get a lot of the questions on these videos, and I want to point out that a lot of these videos were on how to get things set up quick. You know, a lot of them were for file sharing, you know, set them up and get it going on majority of systems with stuff that's already installed. And it seems like a lot of people want to do a lot more advanced stuff than what I was doing in these tutorials. And although you could pull a lot of that stuff off with these techniques, I really do suggest that if you're going to be doing some sort of, you know, more advanced networking, web application stuff, I suggest using a more full web server. I use Apache. It's not the only option out there, but I do recommend it. I like it. But I just wanted to say, if you're going to be doing and having a server set up all the time that people are going to be accessing and you want to do more advanced stuff with, you may not want to use, you know, Netcat or the Python Simple HTTP server. The fact that it's called the Simple HTTP server is, you know, should let you know that it's for doing simple tasks, not running a full-blown web server, although you could, as I've shown in the videos. So it's all up to you what you do, but I do recommend, you know, if you're just going to be sharing files, need to set something up, start that server up, share the files, shut down when you're done. If you're actually going to be running a web server all the time, use a more full, probably could use a better word, a more, I don't want to really say advanced, but I guess advanced web server such as Apache, you know, something with, you know, maybe PHP installed and MySQL if you're going to be doing some database stuff. That's what I use. There's other options. Obviously, you can use Python or whatever server-side scripts you want. So I just wanted to point that out. You know, a lot of people seem to really enjoy those videos and just are trying to take them a little bit further, which is great, but maybe not necessarily the best option for what they're doing. So I just wanted to bring that up. Thank you for watching. Please visit filmsbychris.com. That's Chris with a K. There should be a link in the description. And as always, I hope that you have a great day.